Hi everyone, Steve here again from Photoshop Essentials. Converting type to a smart object has lots of great benefits. One of them, which we'll look at here, is that we can apply filters to our text and still go back and edit the text even with the filters applied. But the usual way of converting a layer to a smart object does not always work with text, at least not if you'll need to edit the text later. Let me show you the problem you can run into when editing text inside a smart object, and then I'll show you an easy solution. I've gone ahead and added some placeholder text in front of a simple background image. We're going to convert the text into a smart object, apply a filter to the text, and then edit the text and see what happens. In the Layers panel, we see my type layer above the background layer. The usual way to convert type to a smart object is to right-click on a Windows PC or Control-click on a Mac on the type layer itself, and then choose Convert to Smart Object from the menu. A smart object icon appears in the lower right of the layer's thumbnail. And with our type now converted to a smart object, one of the things we can do is apply a filter to the text. I'll go up to the Filter menu, and then I'll choose Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. In the dialog box, I'll set the radius, which controls the amount of blur, to around 60 pixels. Then I'll click OK. And we now have some blurry text. So far, so good. Back in the Layers panel, the Gaussian Blur filter appears as a smart filter, which is another benefit of working with smart objects. If I wanted, I could double-click on the smart filter's name to reopen its dialog box and make changes. But I'll click Cancel to close it. What we're more interested in here is that the text itself is also still editable, even with the filter applied. All we need to do is double-click on the smart filter's thumbnail to open it and view the text inside it. Photoshop stores the contents of a smart object in a separate PSB document, which we see up in the tab. But notice the size of the canvas in this document. It's much smaller than the canvas in the main document. Instead of having lots of room around the text like we have in the main document, Photoshop has cropped the canvas in the smart object to the exact width and height of the text itself. And this can be a problem if we need to edit the text. And here's why. I'll edit the text by first making sure I have the type tool selected in the toolbar. Then I'll double-click on the text to highlight it, and I'll change the word to blur. And then I'll click the check mark in the options bar to accept it. And here's the problem. The canvas in our smart object was sized to the original text, but my new text is a bit larger than my original text, so the new text does not entirely fit on the canvas. To make it easier to see, I'll temporarily change my text color from white to black. Notice that the top and bottom of the letter B are cut off because the round parts of the letter extend outside the canvas. Same with the bottom of the letter U and the right side of the letter R. I'll change my text color back to white. Then to accept my changes, I'll close the smart object by clicking the X in the Document tab. And when Photoshop asks if I want to save my changes, I'll click Yes, and that would be Save on a Mac. Back in the main document, the smart object updates with my new text and with the Gaussian Blur filter still applied. But we also see those missing parts of the letters, especially the letter R on the right. If I turn the Gaussian Blur filter off for a moment, the problem is easier to see. And that's why the usual way of converting type to a smart object does not always work. At least not if you need to edit the text later. What we really need is a way to convert our type to a smart object that keeps the full canvas size of the main document, so that if we need to edit the text inside the smart object, the new text will still fit on the canvas. And here's how to do it. I'll press Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac a few times to undo my steps and return to my original type layer above the background layer. And this time, before converting the type layer to a smart object, I'll click on the background layer to select it. And then I'll press Ctrl J or Command J on a Mac to add a copy of the background layer above it. We're going to include this background copy layer in with our smart object. With the background copy layer selected, hold Shift on your keyboard and click on the type layer to select both layers at once. Then right-click or Control-click on a Mac and choose Convert to Smart Object, just like we did before. Then open the smart object by double-clicking on its thumbnail. And this time, because we included a copy of the background layer with our type layer, the canvas in the smart object is not cropped around the text. Instead, it remains the same size as the main document. So now that we've solved our canvas size problem, we don't need the background copy layer anymore. So click on the layer in the Layers panel and press Delete on your keyboard to delete it. And this leaves us with our text surrounded by transparency. Close the smart object by clicking the X in the Document tab, and I'll click Yes or Save on a Mac to save my changes. And back in the main document, we again have our text converted to a smart object. I'll quickly apply the same filter to the text by going up to the filter menu, choosing blur, and then Gaussian blur. In the dialog box, I'll again set the radius to 60 pixels and click OK. And we're back to the same blurry text. And now let's try editing the text again. I'll open the smart object by double-clicking on its thumbnail. And just to make the text easier to see, I'll change the type color from white to black. Then with the type tool active, I'll double-click on the text to highlight it, and I'll again change it to blur. But this time, the entire word fits easily on the canvas, with no letters being cut off. I'll click the check mark to accept it. I'll change the type color back to white. Then I'll click the X in the Document tab to close the smart object, and I'll click Yes or Save on a Mac to save my changes. And back in the main document, the smart object updates with my changes to the text, but this time we're not missing any parts of the letters. The entire word is visible. The only problem after editing the text is that it's no longer centered in the main document. So I'll quickly select the Move tool in the toolbar. Then I'll hold the Shift key on my keyboard to make it easier to drag in a straight horizontal line, and I'll drag the text back into the center. And there we have it! That's a better and more flexible way to convert type to a smart object in Photoshop. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.